YouTube, it's Friday, September 23rd. I'm going to try to show you what you're looking at on HI2. This is the behind craft, and we're looking here at Pylades again. Now, last week someone kept saying Pylades on HI1 was the comet. Now, for one thing you should look at, Pylades is up above the ecliptic. It's about 4 degrees above the ecliptic. The comet is almost right on the ecliptic. The Earth is on the ecliptic, the Sun is on the ecliptic. So anything that's above or below the ecliptic is not the comet. Here's your 45P Honda. People are seeing that also on HI1 right now and thinking that's the comet. So we're going to look at the field of views here. You can find this on the website. I'll give you a link to it. This tells you the direction of center of field of view. In other words, what they do is they take the angular field of view of each camera. HI1 has 20 degrees, HI2 has 70 degrees, and they don't start right at the sun. They offset a little ways. HI1 is offset 4 degrees, HI2 is offset 18.7 degrees. So you take your 70 degrees and you add it to 18.7 and you get 88.7. But we're going to take and measure something here. So when I say that HI1 has a field of view of 24 degrees from the sun, that's what I'm doing. I'm measuring from the sun, and 24 degrees out is where, as far as out as it'll see. Same thing over here. You measure it from the sun, as far out as it'll go is 88.7. But it doesn't start until you get 18.7 degrees away from the sun. In other words, they blank out that much. 18.7 degrees away from the sun is blanked out on HI2. So we saw it come in on HI1 when it was within 4 degrees or right at 4 degrees of the sun. Now we're starting to see it come in on HI2 because it's now 19 degrees away from the sun, or it was on the 18th. So what you're going to see here is you're going to see that as the as this Pylades has moved away from the sun, it is now 19 degrees away from the sun. So what does that tell you? It tells you that it is just now coming into view of HI2, because HI2 starts at 18.7 degrees away from the sun. So on the 18th, Pylades started coming into view on HI2. We can check that out. Here's HI2 right here. Here's the 18th at 2 o'clock. That's the same time I have right here. And what do you see right there? You see the Pylades. Note, it is up above the ecliptic. Here's the Jupiter and the Earth, and it is on the ecliptic with the Sun down here. This is the ecliptic. Whatever this is, it's up above the ecliptic. It just happens to be about 19 degrees away from the Sun. So what do we have that's up above the ecliptic about 19 degrees away from the Sun? We have the Pylades again. So here it is, 19 degrees away from the Sun on the 18th, 4 degrees above the ecliptic. The comet is on the ecliptic. It's down here. It's closer to Earth than the Pylades is. You can see the Pylades right there. Here's Earth, way over here where the SOHO is. It's about halfway. So if you're taking a click at ahead, this is what you're going to see. You're going to see the Pylades come into view up above the ecliptic. You're going to see a bunch of trash on there, and here's the Pylades. Now, if this was the comet, it would have to be down on the ecliptic where the planets are, and this is the center of the sun, and it would also have to be much closer to where the Earth is and where it is. So what you're seeing here is you're seeing the Pylades. And if you look at the other movie, this is the high definition version, and I just did the 21st, but you can see the Pylades right over here, and as you see, it almost looks like the Pylades in the last frame right there. Looks an awful lot like it. Plus,
you've got mail.
It's up above the ecliptic. Here's the center of the sun, here's the planets, the ecliptic is down here. The Pylades is 4 degrees above the ecliptic. So this is what you're looking at. You're looking at the Pylades for about the second week running. First it was on HI1. It was supposed to be the the comet breaking up. Now it's coming into you on HI2, and now it's the comet again. Now, it should be easy to understand that the ecliptic is where the comet is, and this is not on the ecliptic. And neither is this. But it is right where the Pleiades should be. Like I say, if you take and you back it up to where it first comes into view, it comes into view right when it should, according to the angle or distance that the camera is looking. It starts looking at right at 19 degrees away from the sun, and it looks out to 88.7. So that's what's going on. You're seeing the Pleiades for the second week in a row, and it gets old after a while. I wish some people would take and study up on this stuff. It's not that hard. I studied up on it. That's why I keep giving you angular distances. I know that HI1 goes out to 24 degrees, and once it gets over 24 degrees, you're not going to see it anymore. That's why I keep saying that if you take and you measure the angular distance over to Elenin right now, this is on the 18th, let's make it right now. If you measure the angular distance from the sun to Elenin right now, it is almost 28 degrees. There's no way it can be on HI1. What you see on HI1 is Honda down here. Honda just happens to be right at 15 degrees, and you can see that fine on the field of view of Stereo B. And you can also see the Pleiades up here. It's just now leaving the field of view on HI1, and it's just entered back here. It entered the field of view on HI2. So there you go. What you're looking at on HI2 at 19 degrees away from the sun is the Pleiades for the second week in a row. It comes into view right there. And it just happens to be right on the 18th, right when it comes into view, and right when it should come into view if you know what the angles are. Alright, so talk to you later.